snap your fingers and go anywhere, anywhere at all, where would you go? Would you go to the bottom of the sea, where none of your problems can find you? Or would you go back to that first snowfall from when you were a kid? The one that doesn't quite feel the same now that you're all grown up? Would you face your worst fear? Or maybe you go to that party you were never invited to? Oh my god, no, not that. Would you go to the future? Or would you go
back to before you were born, when everybody talked like this for some reason?
Maybe you go here. Or here. Or here. Or maybe here. Or here. Maybe you go here. Or would you rather be standing in Rocket Mortgage Treehouse right now, surrounded by thousands of people who, for once, like all the same shit you do? Well, all right then. Let's go there.
Wish I was a star, so I couldn't feel you get in my face. It'd be no big deal, but I miss the way we make it and smile. Don't wanna be stoned and I change my mind. I wish I had eyes in the back of my head, then I could see the places I've been. But then I would know that you're talking shit. I don't wanna know what my friends think. Wish I were my dog out on the lawn, I'd be so glad when I hear you come on. But if I were my dog, I wouldn't live long. I'm sure gonna miss her when she's gone. I wish I could act in a show on TV, 'cause then I could practice not being me. I'll practice my cry, put it into my reel, but you won't believe me when I cry for you. I wish that my brain would trip insights, I nail every joke, I win every fight, but I get too deep with that kind of mind. I don't wanna know the point of life. In some other life, I would be rich. I travel in style, I cover the bill, but couldn't complain about anything small. Nobody grew bad for me at all. If I was cocaine or a bottle of Jack, I'd get invited to every frat. But when you get old and your good days are past, you'll only want me when you're sad. Wish I was a song, you'd be very wild. You follow the dance to me at your prom. I will be there when your baby is born, but 2 or 3 minutes then I'm gone. I wish I was big as my house. I'd sleep on the trees, I'd sleep on the cloud, but I wouldn't fit on my therapist's couch. Rarely use them now. I wish I was dead. I never drink fun. And if I did, or super human, I could be cruel and break all your stuff. Yeah, I'd be loved no matter what. But if I was good, it can't kind of win. 'Cause you would love me, say what I wanna hear. And then you would die, you'd love me to death. I never know who.
Feel young.
talking hello, hello. Last time that I saw your face was recess in second grade, and it made me feel young. Say,
won't you marry me so right? Going out to make me now. And now I don't feel something again. Won't you help me so right? I'm the biggest thing I try.
Goodbye. I said to my bestest buds, we said that we keep in touch, and we did our best. Yeah. All my new friends, we smile at party time, but soon they forget to smile at anything else. Say,
won't you help me sober up? Running out of me now. You have me sober up. All the big kids, they got drunk. And I wanna feel something again. Won't you help me feel something
gentlemen. Every single night before the show, I'm always standing back there and I'm sort of kind of coming up with something to say this exact moment. I always come up with something that sounds kind of cool, confident. Literally every single night, the lights go on and I forget it all because I truly cannot believe how many of you cared to come here tonight. Thank you so much. Since I forgot it, I'm just gonna go ahead and intro the band. Ladies and gentlemen, we are a band called AJR. That is Adam, my name is Jack, and we got Ryan in the glasses there.
Hello.
Yeah, but yeah, before we do the show, I feel like I should address that, you know?
Address what?
You don't know? I feel like you know. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've seen us before, you know I make it very apparent how angry it makes me when Ryan gets the most applause out of the three of us. And it's like that. it sounds like that. And I've been doing some thinking about it, and I'm realizing it's not a very good look on me to feel that, you know, it's not a good color. So like I said, I've been thinking, and I think I'm gonna kind of start caring a little less, maybe start bullying you a little less, be a little nicer, a little more respectful. For instance, I'm never, ever gonna mention the body odor. No, I'm not gonna do it. I'm never gonna say it on stage. I'm also never gonna mention the fact that you wore braces for much longer than the average kid. I'm not gonna say it. No, I'm not gonna say it. I'm definitely not gonna ever mention the fact that your first kiss was in 12th grade and you'd tell everyone it was in 9th grade. I'm not gonna say it. It's not gonna come out of my mouth.
Wow. Jack, you've really grown.
I know. I've been working on it. Thank you. Cleveland, we love each and every one of you. Thank you so much for coming here tonight. Seriously. And I think there is nothing more to be said other than welcome to the Maybe Man Tour.
Songs. This is actually something that we found on YouTube. A fan sort of combined two of our songs and we heard it and it sounded weirdly good. So I guess what we're gonna do now is we're gonna play a cover of a fan playing a cover of our music. Please don't sue us.
Oh. It's time to let you tell me to it, do it today, do it today. Hey! I got food for Tel Aviv, or maybe Japan. And pretty people yelling me to follow the dance. So why do what you tell me to it, do it today? But I can do this shit again. Put your hands up, it's time on. Raise the glass up, it's time on.
So we weren't quite sure where to put this song in the set, or if to play it at all. But we did some thinking, and we realized we had to do it. I don't want to bring down the mood too much. So it helped if you sang along like this.
God is really real. When do you really, really mean him? God with just a beams. When do you suddenly believe it? Hear it loud and clean. Just as long as it's been painted. Life's fucking long till it stops. And God's fucking fatal is not. My dad can't get at bed. There's something in his lungs, I think that's what the doctor said. I gotta leave for Paris now, my van goes on its own. And my dad can't get out of bed. The earth is spinning like it always did. The New York Times is publishing some real important thing. And each day when the world wakes up, our lawns will still be wet. And my dad can't get out of bed. God is really real. When do you really, really need him? Come with just a piece. When do you suddenly believe it? Hear it loud and clear. Just as long as it's convenient. That's fucking long till it stops. God's fucking fatal is not. Now it's late, I really gotta go. And we can't face our feelings, so I'm making lots of jokes. And we won't cry about it, no, we'll be manly men. I love you, it sounds all corny, so I wrote this song instead. I'll sing it for you, Dad, when you get out of bed. I'll sing for you when you're out of bed.
Goodbye. right now the good life. But what am I gonna do with mine? These things take time, mom and dad, they have a good life. But what the hell am I gonna do with mine?
First, this next one was our most Broadway sounding song. After some work, it kind of became our darkest song. When it was finished, it ended up being our weirdest song. But after all that, for some reason, it became our biggest song.
I get up, I get down, and I'm jumping around. In the rumpus and rug, it's so comfortable now. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow. So I got in a bar, and across from the bar, booking wine in my fridge, still I'm not feeling grown. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to go.
Say!
Is it due? Do my password begin with a one or a two? Been the hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow.
Metronome.
Man, I'm up to something. We think I need y'all. Thank you all for coming. I hope you like the show, cause it's on a budget. So we think I need y'all, man. Come on, here we go, man.
Come on!
Here
we
go. So put your best face on, everybody pretend. Let's go out in the bay.
Good. I'm gonna do something right now. This is something I like to do during every single show. The reason I do it, you can see on the screen there with these little things in our ears, they're called in-ear monitors, and they help us hear the music, but at the same time, they're very isolating from you guys, which is not a good feeling. So just for a second, just gonna like point out people in the crowd that I've seen thus far into the show that have sort of caught my attention.
Yeah. I like this.
There's a lot. This one requires a little intro. Very clearly, you guys brought a lot of signs tonight, and people bring a lot of signs, and they're all so great, and there's like birthdays, and there's games and stuff like that. However, there's always one in every crowd that kind of makes me look past them and makes me go, damn, I gotta know what's going on with that one. And it's you, all the way in the back there. It's kind of hard to see, especially with the people in the back. However, yes, okay. Okay, I'm gonna give some context. So her sign, or his sign, I can't see, says cheese, okay? It's very clear. And it's interesting because from the second I came out, it wasn't just holding up a sign. It was very aggressively holding up that sign. She wanted me to see that more than anything in the world. And I'm just wondering, I'm serious. Every single song, instead of her singing How's It Go Again, it was cheese. And there's always one of these signs that I'm so curious, and since she's so far away and I can't hear her, it always makes me kind of formulate whatever was happening for her to bring that sign to the show. What came to my mind was, she's not really a fan, but her friend is a fan, and the girl holding up the sign is kind of obsessed with cheese, and the only way she would agree to go to the show with the friend is if there was cheese here. And the friend said yes, and she was like, she'll forget about it, but she brought the cheese sign, and now that's all she's waiting for. That's kind of where my mind went, you know what I'm talking about? Did I nail it? Is that exactly what's happening?
Did you get it?
I'm getting a nod. I can't believe I got that, yes. Getting a big nod. Everyone's in on it. Without missing a beat, you're in on it too. I feel like my childhood bully is just gonna pop out here. Just, it's all leading back to the big confrontation. Everyone's in on that. Anyway, thanks for coming to the show, even though there's not gonna be cheese. You could leave now. There's no cheese. There's no cheese.
I saw something kind of interesting.
You saw someone.
Yeah, right here in the blue shirt. Let's throw him up on the camera, right in front of you. There he is.
Oh, wow.
Show his face, not his shirt. His face. What's your name?
Patrick.
Mm.
So Patrick's been here. Often people in the front row are sort of the biggest fans, right? They show up early and they know everything. That's sweet.
It's confirmed.
There's the confirmation. Patrick, you have done a magnificent job at knowing zero of the lyrics so far tonight.
Wow.
Can I explain?
Oh, I mean, yeah, go for it.
We were playing like the DJ's Prank Romp. I looked at you, you didn't really know that one. That's okay, that's sort of a deep cut. Mm. But I thought, oh, the good part's coming up. The good part, TikTok hit, Wendy's commercial, unescapable hit. Didn't even ring a bell for you, Patrick.
You didn't know.
No, oh, he admitted it.
Wow.
Patrick's gotten enough screen time. Get him off that camera.
Make some room for the singing customers, Patrick. God damn! You know what I like? The longer Ryan talks, the less you like him. So I'm gonna support that. I'm gonna support that bit. You know what I have to do? This is an interesting one. This is a first, okay? Swear to God, this is a first. It's you, right in front. And I'm gonna tell you what it is. Why don't you actually pass up the sign for a second, then you're gonna come on stage, because that's, oh my goodness. Okay, hold on. Can you hold up this sign with me? Okay, it says, I leave for boot camp tomorrow, I will shave my head on stage. Get up here, let's go. Get up here, let's do it. Do we have a shaver thing? Oh my God, we're all ready. we have Ryan the barber coming out. There he is. Hold on, before we do this, remove the jacket, there we go. Drape that. Oh my God, okay, this is working out very well so far. Hold on, before we do this, what's your name?
Nick.
His name is Nick. Round of applause for Nick for coming up. And are you 100% sure you want to do this? You want me to shave you on stage? Full body shave? Just head? Yes. Oh, okay. I had to offer. You know what? We're gonna give this a shot. You're sure? Let's see if this works. All right, let's go. Oh my God, it's happening, guys. It's happening. Let me know if it hurts. Oh God, this shaver is very slowly running out of battery. I could just tell. This is gonna take a lot longer than I thought. Oh my God, I'm going down the middle first, because we're gonna do like, what is it called, a faux hawk? Okay, there we go. Guys, this is gonna take a lot longer than I thought, so you guys can just kind of talk, because I'm actually having a blast doing this. There we go. How's it? Oh my God. And I kind of didn't account. Is this hurting you? I'm sorry. Is it? Oh my God. It's good. You know what? Should I leave you with the ring around the side of your head or no?
Yeah, leave him balding.
Should I leave him balding? Hey, Nick, would you be okay if I didn't do the whole head and you fixed it up later? That is not a convincing yes. Oh my God. Hold on. I'm gonna do the top here. Are you guys okay waiting while I do this? Because I'm actually having a blast. Yeah, Ryan, just jam on that piano for a little bit. Hey, Nick, I just also want to say, not even a joke, on behalf of everyone, thank you for your future service, my friend. Seriously. Yes. Oh, my God. All right, I'm shaving the sides now. I'm going for the sides. Am I in a dream? This is insane. Oh, my God. Hold on. I'm going to get the front here. Okay, Nick? Am I doing this right? Honestly, I don't even know whether. Am I? Okay, cool. Sorry, Nick. I wish we had a blow dryer to get that off, but we do not. Hold on. All right, let me get the sides here. Oh, Adam's got the vacuum. Bring it out. All right, hold on. Oh my God. I don't think I accounted for it taking this long, guys. I'm really sorry. Should I keep going? Wow. All right. Okay, here we go. This part's gonna be a little easier. Oh yeah. Did someone say you missed a spot? There's a few I missed. Nick, we're getting very close right now. Tell me something about yourself.
What's going on, Cleveland? Let's hear it! The Harry's going, baby, let's go!
Nick didn't hear what I said.
Well, I upload videos on YouTube. That's like one of my big passions. I'm a swimmer and I make swim vlogs. Nick Swag on YouTube. Nick Swag.
I'm now realizing the real reason he came up here was to plug his YouTube channel. All right. Nick, tell us a secret. It can't be about your swim vlogs.
Can't be about my swim life?
Your swim vlogs.
Can I get a drum roll, everybody?
Oh yeah. The drummer is nowhere to be seen. Oh wait, hold on, the drummer's here. Oh, sorry. Let's do it, Chris, drum roll. All right, I'm gonna get the other side.
I'm single. Yeah!
I don't think the swim vlogs are gonna help with that. All right, I mean, honestly, oh God, I'm so close, right here. Hold on, let me just get the side. Okay, if we get some painful comments after this that we wasted everyone's time, I deserve it, but this is kind of sick. I'm still having a great time. Okay, hey Nick, I did like kind of a great job, except you're definitely gonna have to fix it later. Okay, Nick says it's okay and he's gonna fix it later. Round of applause for Nick, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Can I use my hand to do this? Yes, there he goes. This is actually a nightmare, but this worked out really well. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for Chris. Yes. Oh my God, I feel so bad that you have to walk home looking like that, but everyone just like, give him a hug. Thank you so much. Oh, his name is not Chris, I said Nick. Chris is our drummer's name. I'm sorry about that. Nick, once again, thank you for your service, man. Really appreciate it. Seriously. Boy, Nick's hair is never coming off this stage. That vacuum did nothing. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, before we continue with the show, I think we only have about 5 minutes left after that thing. We used up all the time on these. before we continue with the show, I want to say something a little more serious, a little more matter of fact. Sorry, Dane. We've been playing Cleveland for how long?
About 8 years now.
8 years we've been playing Cleveland. Yeah. The first time we came through,
we played at the Grog Shop. There's no way I'll remember.
It's unlikely you were there. I think there was like 40 or 50 people there, which was, it's the first time we played. We couldn't believe anyone showed up. And then we came back, and where did we play?
We did House of Blues.
House of Blues. More of you showed up to that one. And then we came back and...
This was last time we were here. We're at the Wallstein Center.
Wallstein.
Yeah.
And that was insane. That kind of blew our mind. I think there was like 4,000
people
there. And House of Blues, we had like 1,000. And we kind of just couldn't believe it last time. We're like, holy shit, we made it in Cleveland, we did it. And just the reason I say all this, ladies and gentlemen, is I just want to tell you that tonight, there are over 10,000 people in this room. And, you know, we've been doing this a really long time. We've made a lot of friends in the music industry, a lot of artists' friends, and some of which have kind of stopped doing it for whatever reason. You know, fans couldn't keep up or they weren't feeling it anymore. And just the reason I tell you that, Cleveland, is just to show you guys how unbelievably rare this is. This does not happen in our industry. I'm serious. So just from the bottom of the three of our hearts, thank you so much for letting us do this. Thank you for coming. Cleveland, thank you, thank you, thank you! We love you so much. They get it. We get it. Let's keep this show going right now.
I'm not afraid to so good this year.
Thinking I was in love, another song about me realizing I wasn't in love at all, and then a third song about actually falling in love.
Closer than I ever knew I could do, but I'm confused. I thought I'd recognize when love was true, but I'm confused. Am I ready for love? Or maybe just a best friend? Should there be a difference? Do you have instructions? Maybe I'm stuck on what I see on TV. I grew up on Disney, but this don't feel like Disney.
I think I probably wasn't in love with you.
idea of you. And though I may be missing the feeling of you, I think I probably wasn't in love with you. I said it cause I no longer wanna hurt. I said it back to you cause you said it first. And though I may be wishing it wasn't true, I think I probably wasn't in love. I wasn't in love with you. Got it out of my system, didn't I? Did my 2 years on Tinder, didn't I? Well, I wanted to be wanted. Suddenly I'm wanting more. So we got a bit tangled, didn't we? It's the best thing that's happened to me. Got exactly what I wanted. What if I don't want this? Am I missing something? But half the time I can't love right, and I can't have sex and we both get quiet. I must be one fucked up guy.
So let's sing it together. Bye. fighting World War II. He was such a noble dude. I can't even finish school. Kissed my mom and left too soon. His step was a fireman who fought fire so violent. I pick up on my therapist by playing him my violin.
Oh my God,
that's so insane. Gonna be like, do things get this end? Okay! The world is small, it's violent. Really needs an audience. So if I do not about to fight it soon, all the weapons are spittering. Since we're not tired, it's happening. Just let me play my violin for you, you, you.
That's right. When he was such a noble dude, and I feel like such a fool. I got so much left to prove. All my friends are making friends. They're so good at making friends. I'm so scared of getting in. Is that entertaining?
Oh my God,
that's so insane.
Oh my God,
that's such a shame. Thanks to them, my shit don't feel so great. But I can't help myself feeling bad. I'm gonna feel like two things can be said.
To join us for this part. Yeah? Let's sing it together.
I'll blow up bass of smithereens and spill my tiny symphony all up and down the city street while trying to put my mind at ease. I can't achieve this melody. This feels like a necessity. So this could be the type of thing I'm maybe just a better one. I'm coming with the temperance to take a shot at Hennessy. I know I'm not meant to leave, but you got me the remedy. So where we play my
so much.
Thank you, Cleveland.
That went well. How you doing? You good? Yeah? Did I brush your knee a little there during that song? I did it. I think I did, and I think you were just okay with it. A little sweat on his knee. Ladies and gentlemen, since it went well, we're gonna play another song from up here. One more song. And this is also a sing-along, so let's do it again.
Steve's going on lightning. Sean's stuck in a soup. Tom sleeps on his best friend's lawn like every other afternoon. Steve's going on lightning. Dan beating the boat. Tom fell for his best friend's mom. But what the heck gonna do? Like seeds growing on a knee.
prices, going to London, shows stuck in a soda. It's all sings on his best friend's lawn, like every other afternoon. Steve's going to London, there's meeting the fool. It's all stuck on his best friend's mom. Songs. I was out with something so fun, trying to put my shoes on. Now something kinda clicked, cause you were late a bit. But no one's gonna care about a shoe song. I try hard to write a cool song, but I gotta make it matter, so maybe I'll throw the news on. Could I relate the shoes to 2022? Or maybe an election down in Tucson? I tried throwing something cool on, so I'm listening to Kendrick and playing that swimming pool song. Oh, why did I do that? Cause now I hate my track. Quite aware I never write a cool song, but who really needs a cool song? And there's so many better melodies writing you need a new one. So stop writing a song, about writing a song. You listen their attention, but it won't bother.
Please go into London.
What the hell?
Song,
I got you back to stay.
Like
alright, just keep singing till I get there.
While we wait for Jack to make his way back to the stage, I want to take a moment to introduce the incredibly talented musicians we have up here with us tonight. Up first, there's a pretty new addition to the AJR touring crew. Tonight, you've seen her play saxophone and violin. It's my pleasure to introduce Miss Ginny Lou.
Say it loud, say it loud, nice.
Used to keep it cool, used to be a fool. All about the person myself. Watch it on the news, what you gonna do? Back in your profession, forget. Used to keep it cool. Yeah. No one's gonna listen to me. If I write a song, preach your money strong, will they let me sing on TV? Should I keep it alive? Hey, like a bride. Let's play it!
Experiment a lot, produce with a lot of layers, experiment, try and find weird sounds you don't normally hear in music. So if it's all right with you guys, I'm gonna show you how we produce one of our songs, okay? Now this one is special, because it took us 20 years to create. Okay, we were working, we started with a kick drum, like this. Can you slow down that kick drum a little bit? More. Yeah, that's better. Then we went about looking for a hi-hat. Okay, we started with this. But could you speed up that hi-hat a little bit? More. Yeah. Okay, cool. So far we had a kick, we had a hi-hat. And after 5 minutes of producing, we were exhausted. So we decided to go to lunch. And I remember we were at lunch, we ordered our food, and the waiter came back and he put down the plate in a very interesting way. Okay? It sounded like this. Sounded cool. So we had the waiter do it again, and we recorded it this time, like this. Then we went about flamming the sound. Now, flamming a sound is when you play the same sound over itself, out of time from itself. I'll show you what I mean. Flam it more. More. Yeah, now pitch it down an octave. Okay, we had our clap. So far we had a pretty good kick drum, we had a good clap, and we had a good hi-hat. And with those three drums, we set about trying to find a groove. So we started with this reggaeton kind of beat. But that didn't really feel like AJR. So we tried this doo-wop thing. But we had done that before. So we ended up settling on this halftime trap sort of beat, like this. Yeah, good start. Okay, next we wanted to find a piano line. And we wanted a piano line that felt very emotional. Kind of like this. Hey. Then we added some bass, like this. Yeah, that feels good. Let it ride for a sec. Okay, we had a good start. We had the skeleton of the beat, but after working, we sort of got bored again, which seems to be a common theme in our work. So we went to the library. I remember we were at the library in our college, and I was working, and Jack was watching old home movies on his phone for some reason.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Put your hands closer together, please.
And I remember I looked from my work to Jack on his phone, and I just got so annoyed that I blurted out, "Would you put your phone down?" And Jack looked at me, and he said, "Say that again." So I said, "Would you put your phone down?" Then we called up Arnetta, and we said, "Could you play that on the trumpet?" Okay, we had our trumpet melody. So far. But we still wanted it to be more emotional. So for that, we used violins. And finally, to fill out the drums a little more, we added these hi-hats and tambourines. Okay, we were almost there. There was one more step. We had a really solid track, but what we needed was a really good melody to go on top of that track. And as Jack often does, he sent me a voice memo. But that wasn't catchy at all. So he sent me this one. But that was less catchy than the first one. We were kind of stuck here. We needed a melody, right? And then we remembered those old home movies Jack was watching in the library.
Put your heads close.
And do you remember at the start of this story, I told you it took 20 years to create this song? Here's why.
Don't you love it, no, I ain't happy yet. Say! But I'm way less sad.
and I'm losing my mind. Cause it's half past three, my brain's on fire. I've been counting sheep, but the sheep all die. And I'm trying so hard, but I cannot trust.
Well, I can't fall asleep, and I'm losing my mind.
Baby,
Can we get work lights on right now, please? What the f- we need people on stage. Did a light just fall? There's glass on the stage right now. Are you guys okay? This is not part of the show, guys. Sorry. They're gonna send people on right now to clean this up. We'll be right back.
I should have said I should be instead. But temptations of trouble on my tongue, troubles yet to come. Like
one hit,
bad for me.
One hit,
bad for me.
One kiss,
bad for me. I give it so easily. Enough, thank you. It's how it should have gone. I should stay strong. They call me after dark. I don't want no bars. And my habits, they hold me like a grudge. I promise I won't budge. Check it out. Nice. Bad for me. Bad for me. Bad for me. I give it so easily. No, thank you. It's so it should have gone. I should stay strong.
I'm
this before, you know we always like to do a big, crazy finale. But I'm gonna say something first, that's all right. In the 18 years we've been a band, one thing has been constant. There's always been some people who absolutely fucking hate us. No, it's true. No, I remember back in high school, some of the kids made like an anti-AJR club. That's what they called it. And they would meet at lunch, and they would really just sort of talk about how bad they thought the music was. And I don't know, maybe it was like the Broadway kind of sound we had. I really don't know. But at the end of the day, it made us feel really small. Fast forward 10 years, the band started to do a little better. We had meetings with record labels, and all of them said the same thing. They said, we're going to put you in a room with writers. We're going to change everything about you. Even today, it's kind of hard to escape. You know, it feels like everyone on the internet has some kind of opinion about the things that we do on stage or the weird topics we're writing songs about. But every step of the way, Cleveland, every step of the way, there's been one thing that's kept us from listening to those people. And that, Cleveland, that was our dad. Yeah. Even up until last year, it was our dad who said, keep going. Keep going, and eventually one day, you will find some people who see the world the same way you do. He was right, and now he's gone. In an instant, he's just not here anymore. And my dad had his flaws, but one thing I could say about him is he was really, truly, unapologetically himself. Every inappropriate joke he made at a dinner party, every time he embarrassed us by wearing AJR merch to a parent-teacher conference, he was being truly himself. And on his last day alive, we were in the hospital joking around, saying goodbye. We asked him what his biggest piece of life advice was. And he said, don't ever spend one second of your life not being yourself. Go be the biggest version of yourself. And it's a scary thing to do, but I'm gonna say something right now that I've wanted to say for a very, very long time. Fuck those high school bullies! Fuck those record labels! Fuck the internet critics that don't get what we're doing up here! For the rest of our life, we're gonna stand on this stage, walking on treadmills, bringing shadows to life, singing our weird songs! Because Cleveland, after 18 years, we finally found a room of people that see the world the same way we do! Because life is really, really short, guys. It's way too short to not be the biggest version of yourself.
I wish I was me, whoever that is. I could just be, and not give a shit. Hey, I'll be whatever makes you a fan, cause I don't know who the hell I am. I think it's too late to figure this out. If I could be me, I would've been in by now. Maybe I'm a stone as big as my house. It looks like our time is running out. So if this is me, then I'll do my best. I'll take all the shade so you never have to. You can be you, and I'll be the rest. Yeah, maybe that's all.
I gotta get better, I'm all the-